If someone would have told me that 5 years after coming to Canada, I would have grown into the individual that I am today, I would not have believed them. I have experienced both ups and downs during this journey. Over the last 5 years while studying at the Mount, I lost my grandfather, my grandmother, as well as my father. Mount St. Vincent University has allowed me to grow in ways that I would have never imagined possible. I have learned the importance of pressing on, keeping the end in view, as well as keeping the faith. Here, I made a group of forever friends. I have had classroom discussions that have challenged me to become a critical thinker. And I have even had the pleasure of slipping down Everest's hill at least 10 times due to the snow, and can now check that off of my bucket list. You know, every Islander should be able to say that at least once. On a more serious note, over the past 5 years, I have transformed immensely. I view situations differently, I speak differently, and I have become an individual who can see the bigger picture of situations. For example, I have learned to ask myself questions like, why does this matter? What can I do to change or improve this? I guess I have learned to become a problem solver rather than someone who is happy with the old traditional way of existing. If you see a problem and you believe it is worth fixing, try to change it. Try to be that change. I am from a very small island in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean called Bermuda. Yes, for those of you wondering, I mean like the triangle. Bermuda is known to be a small place, 21 square miles to be exact. It is a place where change and progressiveness occurs on an even smaller scale. When I came to the Mount in 2015, I would describe the 2015 Shannon as being someone who was complacent. I mean, do not get me wrong, my friends and family know me as someone who always seeks to set personal goals and accomplishes them. But I mean the bigger picture of things. I mean complacent with situations that occur around me. I was never one to challenge situations or to even think critically about them. I would know that when a situation was not right, but would simply sweep it under the carpet and continue on as if it did not exist. What do I mean? So take something as serious as feminist issues to be exact. For starters, I will completely be oblivious to the feminist movement. Never would I ever speak up on feminist issues. To be honest, I was often a part of the problem, making comments like, why are you acting like a female? Or saying things like, why is he acting like a little girl? And this was honestly because those are things that I heard growing up and would never question. Instead, I would perpetuate the same ideas. Only when I came to Canada, and more specifically to the Mount, I was educated on the dangers of those ideas and how harmful they could be to the growth and progression of both women, girls, men, and young boys alike. Digging a little deeper, I will go further to discuss racial issues. Bermuda's population is made up of the majority of Black Bermudians. However, as a people, we are not taught about our history. We are often complacent with present day, but many are oblivious to the racial divide that still exists on our island, which has a direct impact on education, salaries made, as well as lifestyles. Yet, we hardly have anything as much as a protest to demand change. This is a complacency that I was trapped in. My first year at Mount St. Vincent, I took a class with Jonathan Roberts, who encouraged me to write a paper about a riot or a revolutionary movement that occurred in Bermuda. My initial response to him was that an event like that had never taken place. He sat with me and we researched and found out that there were multiple social unrest that took place on the island due to social unrests. And I was able to find a variety of sources in order to write my 20-page paper. While I was happy to have been able to write my paper around my island home, I was left feeling a bit uneasy. It had taken me to be overseas receiving a higher education to find out such important history that was directly tied to me and my home. It was this awakening that fostered a love for social justice issues and thinking of ways that I can help tackle these problems. Becoming a teacher is what I chose as my avenue to create change in my community and for my island. A teacher is someone who helps to educate the future generations, who seeks to equip young people with the knowledge and tools that they need to make critical choices in their lives and the greater world at large. The knowledge, new ways of viewing the world, and open-mindedness that I have acquired over the past 5 years here at the Mount has prepared me to educate young people. challenging them to think critically about social issues that are apparent in their communities, but to also think of ways that they can improve these issues. This is what gives me most pleasure in my profession. This is how I can bring about change within my community. So today, my fellow graduates of 2020, I challenge all of you to think for a moment. Throughout your studying here at Mount St. Vincent, what have you learned about yourself? Have you discovered a passion? Has your journey led you to find out something new about yourself? Do you believe that the knowledge that you have acquired throughout these years has equipped you to make some kind of difference, whether it is small or large? If you answered yes to any of those questions, you need to follow that passion. Find ways and opportunities that you can make even the smallest change, whether it is in your circle of friends, in your workplace, and even in an organization that you are a member of. And remember, your change does not have to be so big that you will be known as and remembered like Martin Luther King or Malcolm X. Earlier, I mentioned that I experienced my biggest obstacles to date, which was losing 3 family members while studying. The skill that I learned from those significant events is that in life, we face roadblocks and challenges, but we must stay true to our purpose. Creating change is not easy. You will encounter obstacles that may seem to knock you off course, but it is always important to keep the end in view and to remember your purpose, the reason for your change. As long as you know within yourself that you have made a difference, the littlest change to someone else's life perhaps, then that is enough. We need to acknowledge that that is a big deal, because change, little by little, bit by bit, can and will work to improve our lives, our communities, and will help transform the world into a much better place. Thank you.